Welcome to day 7 of our creative design team video collab entitled 31 Days of Christmas. If you are just joining us, here are a few things you might want to know. There are 7 of us who will be posting Christmas card ideas all through the month of October for you to enjoy, so you can get a head start on all of your Christmas card creating. You will also want to make sure that you click down in the description below. You're going to see these little words that say show more, or you'll see a little drop down arrow, and that will give you a list of all of the ladies' channels so that you can subscribe to each one and be notified when they add a new project throughout the month of October. You're also going to see a supply list in that description. So if you decide you want to recreate the cards you are making, you can purchase the supplies from one of us. We will be posting a playlist on the 31st of October so you guys can view all of the cards we've created when you start creating your own Christmas cards, okay? We want you to have fun because this video collab is full of ideas for you, and we cannot wait to see what you create. Let's go ahead and get started with today's Christmas card project. We are going to be using the layered floral background dies for both of our Christmas cards today. When you stack all 3 of these layers together, they create a beautiful multi-layered background. How pretty is that? So I have already cut 1 of my pieces out of scarlet cardstock, another out of scarlet glitter paper, and now we're going to cut the top piece out of French vanilla cardstock. I'm just going to run this through my die cutting machine real quick, remove all of the excess pieces using my piercing tool to help me with those tiny little dots. And now all I have to do is glue these layers together. These layers fit together so nicely. I have found that it's best to start with the top layer, just adding a tiny bit of glue around the edges. Then you're going to want to make sure all of your corners are nice and square, and then you're going to add the bottom layer. Once that bottom layer is glued on and all squared up on the edges, you can adhere it onto your card base. Now, whatever color your card base is going to show through all of those little openings. So you can change your card base to any color you want. I chose French vanilla, or you could leave it white and have the white show through. Now I'm just going to set this card base aside, placing a couple blocks on top to help it set. And while that dries, we're gonna start stamping our poinsettia images using the Comfort and Joy scrapbooking stamp set. You can choose to purchase the matching thin cut dies with this stamp set so that you can cut out all of the images. We're going to be using those poinsettia stamps today to create a flower for our card. Whenever I have images with matching dies, I like to lay the stamp down onto the VersaMat and then pick it up with my block. This helps the stamp to keep its shape so that it matches your thin cut die when you go to cut it out. So I'm just going to stamp 3 flowers on French vanilla cardstock using scarlet ink. Once I have all 3 of those flower images stamped, I'm going to cut them out with those matching thin cuts, and then we're going to create the poinsettia flower. So here I've cut out those flower shapes, and I've also cut out some vellum shapes using the same thin cuts. Now we're going to go ahead and just shape everything with our fingers and stack it using some foam tape. Now you might be wondering why I didn't stamp this bottom layer in green. It's supposed to be the leaves after all. I wanted this to be a monochromatic card, so I've chosen to make this bottom layer red, just like all the other layers, so that I have a deep red multi-layered poinsettia flower. If you've watched me create 3D flowers in the past, you know that I like to add multiple layers of thin and thick 3D foam tape. I like having a big, fluffy, multi-dimensional flower on my cards. So once I have all of those stamped layers and those vellum layers created, I decided that I wanted to add a top layer to this flower. And this little piece could be used as a separate flower, but I'm choosing to use it as a top layer on the design. Since this flower is the same color as the other layers, I decided to add some additional color using a watercolor pencil.
After I've added a little bit of shading onto the flower, then I took my clear shimmer brush and drug that color onto the petals. This next step is something I'm excited about. I used to buy a product for the center of my flowers that was non-close to my heart, but now that we carry these beads, I can use them instead. So I'm starting out by pooling a little bit of liquid glass in the center of the flower, and then I'm going to dump these little beads right there onto the liquid glass. I'm just going to use my finger to pile them in the center and shape them a little bit. And now I have the look of little tiny flowers in the center of that poinsettia. Now I'm just going to carefully shape the petals, being cautious that I don't touch any of those beads in the center because they're not quite set yet. And then I'm going to stack this flower on top of the other layers using some 3D foam tape. And now our little stamped poinsettia is all complete. Take a look at all the layers on that flower and all of that vellum there at the bottom. How pretty is that? This is going to look great on our card. So I've already cut a 1-inch strip of Comfort and Joy plaid paper that my poinsettia is going to set atop of, and I'm trying to decide where I want the sentiment. Instead of battling with that decision, I've decided just to get all of my images stamped, and then I'll figure that out later. So I've grabbed some berries here, and I've grabbed that Merry Moments sentiment, and we're going to stamp them using intense black ink onto French vanilla cardstock. I'm also going to be adding some pine boughs to this card, which are going to be stamped and heat embossed with gold embossing powder. I'm just stamping each one of the images using Versamark ink. I'm going to sprinkle on some fine gold embossing powder, and then off camera, I'm going to heat set each one of those images and then cut out everything using those matching thin cut dies. So as you can see, I have those gold pine boughs, the black berries, and the sentiment. My poinsettia center is all set, and we're going to start assembling the card. I'm going to start by placing the flower down using some 3D foam tape, and then I'm going to grab some thick and thin foam tape and start placing all of those elements around the flower. To complement the gold heat emboss pine boughs, I decided to grab a snowflake sticker from the Comfort and Joy sticker sheet. The sentiment is going to stick right on top of that snowflake, and it just adds a little bit more gold element to the card. Now at this point, I felt like my card was off balance, and I couldn't quite figure out why. And so I decided to grab this polka dot zip strip from that Comfort and Joy paper, and I've tucked it under the plaid paper. So if you decide to make this card, you're going to want to make sure you do that zip strip before you do everything else. So now that I've added that little zip strip, I'm just going to go ahead and complete the assembly of the card by adding the rest of those gold pine boughs, the snowflake sticker, and the sentiment, all of them being layered onto the card using both thin and thick 3D foam tape. To add a little bit more of that gold bling, I've grabbed some gold gems here, and I'm just going to place them onto the card. And now this design is complete. I love how this card turned out with that floral background and the black and gold and scarlet red elements. All right, so now we're going to make a second card using those layered floral background dies, but this time we have a little bit of a twist. This time I'm going to be using a PML card or Picture My Life card for the front. Now we are going to have to make a couple of alterations to this design. The die is 4 1/4 wide and the PML card is only 4 inches. But I really liked the pattern on this PML card, so I thought, hey, why not? We're going to try to make this work. I've placed the PML card pattern side down onto the die, and then I'm using some post-it tape to hold it in place so that it's nice and centered. I'm going to run it through my die cutting machine, then we're just going to remove all of the tape and all of the little parts and pieces and take a look at how this cut. You can see that it will fit on top of the other layers, but we're just a little bit short on the edges. So we're going to go ahead and fix this. The first thing I'm going to do is trim off the excess edge on that PML card. So there was just a sliver of a frame that existed, and I'm going to go ahead and trim it off. I'm also going to trim the frame around that glitter layer. I want a green frame all around the edge of the card, but as you can see, this doesn't look quite finished. So I've gone and cut a New England Ivy rectangle frame, and I'm going to glue it on top of all the layers. This finishes off the card. Now all I have to do is glue this down onto a French vanilla card base, and we've been able to use that PML design as the front of our card. So we made it work. On this card, I'm also going to use that Comfort and Joy stamp set with the thin cut dies. As you can see, I've already stamped all of the flower images in scarlet, and I have cut out the leaves using New England Ivy. Before I start assembling the flower, I do want to add a little bit of shimmer to a couple of the elements. So I've grabbed a clear shimmer brush here, and I'm just brushing all of those leaves with a little bit of shimmer. And then I'm also going to add some shimmer to this small little tiny flower. Once I've done that, I'm going to bend and shape the leaves by just creating a little crease in the center. And then I'm going to layer all of the elements of the flower using thin and thick 3D foam tape. Each one of the layers is rotated slightly so that the layer underneath shows through. On this poinsettia, I stamped two of the larger flowers, and these are being layered on top of each other. I'm going to use that smaller layer as a separate poinsettia. Now these are going to sit here right on top of the card, and we're going to be decorating this card using Comfort and Joy stickers. Like I always do, I've grabbed my anti-static pouch here, and I'm going to be removing the stickiness from all of the stickers that I'm using. I've chosen to use these two gold leaf images with the swirls and the Silent Night sticker for the sentiment. I've also stamped a couple of pine boughs in black, and these are going to be used to accent the card. Now I'm just going to grab some thin and thick 3D foam dots, and I'm going to start adding all of these layers onto my card. I've got that gold leaf image, the Silent Night sticker, my two poinsettia flowers. Both of these are going up on some thicker foam tape. And then I'm going to add those black pine boughs that I stamped and cut out using those thin cuts. These just get placed right around the card, and these match that black Silent Night sticker. So it forms kind of a visual triangle for us here. I've decided to add a little bit more gold on the card, so I've grabbed some gold embellishing thread. I'm going to create a tiny little loop around my finger. Connect the loops using a glue dot, and then this is going to get tucked right there behind the sticker. To add a little bit more bling to the card, I'm going to put some gold gems right in the center of the poinsettia. I have three of them right there, and then I'm going to put a large gem right there on the smaller poinsettia behind the other flower. I'm just going to trim up that gold embellishing thread, add another little leaf sticker here on the left side, and this card is complete. And now we have two completed Christmas cards using those layered floral thin cut dies. Let's take a look at each one of these individually. Here we have a monochromatic card using gold and scarlet with that beautiful poinsettia right there on top. On the other card, we used a PML card and a bunch of sticker accents in gold and black. I just love how I was able to get two completely different unique looks using those layered floral background dies and the Comfort and Joy stamp set. I hope that you are inspired to try something new on your own Christmas cards, and that you continue to join us with our 31 Days of Christmas Cards video collab. Each day of the week, a member of our creative design team will be creating a Christmas card or a number of Christmas cards for you. So I encourage you to click the subscribe button for each one of their channels so that you don't miss out on any of those Christmas card ideas. Every Wednesday, I will be adding a new Christmas card project to my blog and YouTube channel. If you enjoyed today's project and wish to see more in the future, make sure to click that subscribe button and notification icon so you're notified when new videos are added. If you'd like to see some of our past Creative Design Team projects, you can click on the collection icon above. I hope you have a wonderful week, and I can't wait to see what you create.